Long, long, long time ago was nothing. Close your eyes and you see nothing. Genesis 1:1. In the beginning, God created everything. Then he created man and a woman. Everything went fine for a while, and then it happened. Satan the devil told the lady, Eve, if she ate the fruit from the tree of good and evil, she could be as smart as a god. God told Adam not to eat from that tree, and he told Eve only one rule to obey. But she pulled the fruit and ate it. So did Adam. That's when sin entered the world, and that's why we are all born with the nature to do wrong things. And God, way back then, had a plan. He set about telling us his plan through many prophets. That plan would happen many years from that day. Day by day, he waited until the right minute. And then the time had come, 2,000 years ago.
My body was like a precious jewel, with limbs like brass, a face like lightning, and eyes like flaming torches. Later, we angels were sent as messengers to the prophets. Some messages were messages of warning, but some were messages of hope. A Messiah, a Savior was to come who would conquer the enemy and take away sin forever. I was asked to carry news of this great event. I was asked to bring this message to Mary, that she would bear a child. I have to go deliver the message. You who are highly favored, the Lord is with you.
Greatly disturbed at his words and wondered what kind of greeting this might be, but angel said to her,
the child to be born will be called the Son of God.
I'm the Lord's servant. May it be to me as you have said.
I am a humble hand and cannot understand the great things what the angels spoke. I am unworthy of such an honor, and this was a great responsibility. I knew there would be gossip. In this small town, Nazareth, everyone wants to know everything. I chose to obey God when he entrusted me in his work. Are you ready to do the same?
I am Joseph. I am a carpenter who was engaged to Mary. That when it was discovered that Mary was with a child, my heart was deeply troubled. The angel of the Lord appeared and told me the things beyond my understanding. Because the command of the angel, I gladly took Mary as my wife. I understand the terrible bondage that we live under. I knew God, but the angel said that you should call his name Jesus, for he will save his people from their sins. Jesus is the only one who could save us from our sins. Will you accept him for this Christmas?
In those days, Caesar Augustus, who was a ruler in Rome, issued a decree that census should be taken from the entire Rome world. And everyone went to this town to register. So Mary and Joseph, and the time had come for them to be born.
But I'm happy that he was born in a stable at my inn. He was born 2,000 years ago in a stable. Will you let him be born in your hearts today?
While they were there, the time came for the baby to be born, and she gave birth to her firstborn, a son. She wrapped him in cloths and placed him in a manger, because there was no room for them in the inn. And there were shepherds living in the fields nearby, keeping watch over their flocks at night. An angel of the Lord appeared to them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them. And they were terrified, but the angel said to them,
thank you.
I was asked to bear the good news on the first Christmas day. Will you do the same this Christmas?
Can we go to Bethlehem?
Yes, let's go see the baby.
Yes, let's go.
Immediately we set out to find the baby and found him in a stable wrapped in swaddling clothes.
In those days, we shepherds were looked down, not trusted, and even scorned. I am sure that he will let us know the first news to emphasize that he came to this world for everyone, especially for the poor and lowly.
We are the three wise men. We came from the east and followed the star to Bethlehem.
The star signified a new king for the Jews, and we choose to pay our respects and worship him with gifts.
We know the story. Most of us heard it many times before, but it is ages as it is true. The Messiah who spoke in the prophecies had come, and the world would never be the same.
Die on the cross to save his people from their sins. as the angel had foretold.
Died on the cross, he rose from the dead on the third day, and later ascended into heaven, proving that God made this Jesus whom you crucified both Lord and Christ.
This story of prophecies fulfilled is still there in the Bible today for anyone to read.
You have seen how each one of them have chosen by God and how they responded. God has chosen each and every one of us here to be his children and be saved from our sins. How would you want this Christmas to be in your lives?
With Jesus or without Jesus?
Thank you. Yes, it's true. We know He loves us. Yeah. We